I love to paint, especially without a goal. Without a finish line, without a picture in my head. I love the freedom it can bring. Unfortunately, that isn't always the case, because here I clearly mess up somehow. So let me show you a way that can help to bring back the fun in a painting project. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. Recently, I came across the art of Emily Mason, a for me unknown master of abstract. I just love her artwork. It has a kind of balance or serenity that makes me feel relaxed and at ease. There's a link in the description below the video to an artist's portrait of her. Let's go a few steps back to how I began my project. A sheet, and I use a number of 10 by 15 centimeter postcard size pieces to see how many will fit. I measure and draw the outline of 13 pieces. I know I can't stand in Emily Mason's shadow, but this doesn't mean I can't have fun being inspired by her. Working with smaller paintings saves paper and paint and is less intimidating to me. So I continue in the second rectangle. But when I keep doing what I do, I will keep getting what I get. And again, I get a no. Let me first state that a no doesn't have to be a bad thing. Let me show you this decorative item. Quick and easy to make, or to take down again. It's like my project. I start and get an internal no and give up. Look, I wrote a mirrored N. Interesting. I can also continue and earn a second no. In my case, painting always comes with challenges. But the experience also taught me that doing always brings me further. Any tried idea always leads to more ideas. Perhaps this time a yes. And a yes can open up a whole new and different world. So doing is my mantra. To help myself, I create a passepartout to cover up my distracting nose. I try a different approach, and this one looks promising. Over to you. Let me turn this into a challenge, because several of you already asked for it. You can find all the technical details about the challenge in the description below the video. Back to the artistic challenge this time. Emily Mason worked process-based. I invite you to do the same. Just start somewhere, with a color you like. Forget about all the images in your mind or around you. Focus on your paper or canvas instead. Paint your first color. Now ask yourself, or ask your painting, whatever works better for you, what it needs. Does it need a darker or a lighter color next to it? Will a small part be enough? Or is a larger one better? Stop in between to scan. You can use an internal judge to help you or work the way you like. But do constantly stop and pause for a second. It may feel strange at first in case you are not used to working like this. See yourself in a learning mode. You can always go back to your normal routines tomorrow. But for now, just try this approach. I sometimes walk away from my painting in case I don't know how to continue. I go grocery shopping, read a book, step into the garden, just to occupy my mind with other activities. Of course, the painting will dry while I'm gone, but this can also be a new way of working. Here are a few examples from my painting course. I gave them the same exercise. Put one color on your palette. Paint something and stop. What could be your next move, based on the first step? After you decide, exchange ideas with the person next to you. Ask what he or she thinks is interesting for your painting. Now choose a second color and add something to your painting and stop again. A bunch of the participants hated being interrupted all the time. But doing things differently, if only once, can help you become aware of your painting routines and perhaps help to change your ways of doing and also the outcome. For this challenge, you can use any material you like. Take for instance your favorite watercolors, or use a palette knife. I'm like this bag full of wonderful colored lids. Let's say my normal behavior is like this. But by picking a new set of options, I can create a routine that looks like this. Interesting to see all these smaller lids get stuck in the bigger ones. What will my routine be at that moment? I definitely have more options, as always. To give you some more options to play with, I start like this. Each one of these smaller paintings I will finish in the coming weeks, and I will show them to you in my video at the end of June 2022. Where I also will show all the artwork you submitted. I will show you a selection of the artwork of the participants of my local painting course as well. Let's go back to the first one to show how I continue. I get the feeling I can use some quietness, so I just start painting. When you send me your artwork, first read about the details in the description below the video. Tell me in the email your first name and the country you live in. I will show both next to your artwork. I also really appreciate it when you share a line or two what you experienced while painting. I'm already looking forward to receiving your artwork. While painting, I do get the idea the painting looks better. But I also get the idea I'm not there yet. We'll see. In case you'd like to see how such a challenge video will look like, just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.